Hi, I am Asghar Gauri. In this video titled How to Create and Activate Swap Space in a Disk Partition, I'll show you how to initialize a disk partition for use as a swap and how to enable it to auto-activate at future system reboots. Though enough swap space is usually established at the time of Linux installation, however, large applications and databases usually require a large amount of additional swap space for operational and performance reasons. For this video, I have already created a 200 MB disk partition called SDB2 on my system. For information on how to create a disk partition using the Partit program, refer to my other video on disk management titled How to Create and Delete Partitions in Linux with the Partit program. Let's get started. Here's a list of the commands that I'll be using in this video. The lsvlk command is used to list the disks and their partitioning status. The mkswap command is used to create swap structures in a partition. The swap on and swap off commands are used to activate and deactivate swap in a disk partition. And the free command is used to view swap space usage and activation status. Let's run the lsvlk command on the system to check for the presence and size of the SDB2 partition. lsvlk. The output indicates that there is a partition SDB2 right here, 199 megabytes in size. So we use the mkswap command and we specify the device file path of the disk partition where we want to create swap structures. And there you go. It says setting up swap space sizes approximately 200 megabytes, and this is the UUID that it generated automatically. I will show you how to use this UUID in the fstab file for auto activation of the swap area at system reboots. Let's activate this swap area. But before we activate the swap area, I want to show you the current status and current size of the swap area that we have available on the system. We use the free command for that purpose. Free with minus lowercase m option to show us the sizes in megabytes. There is 1639 megabytes of swap space currently configured on the system. So I'm gonna activate the area that we just created. Sudo swap on /dev/sdb2, and we run the free command again to view the updated status. 1838 megabytes is currently available as swap space. So we have 1838 minus 1639 is the new swap space area. I'm going to deactivate this swap using the swap off command, and I'll copy the UUID associated with the swap area, and I'm going to open my fstab file and add an entry for this swap area. Press the letter O and then right click to paste the UUID. There is no mount point for the swap area, so we use swap, type is swap, and we use defaults. We don't want to use any non-default options here, and 00. That's it. Save the file, exit out of the VI editor, and now we can use the swap on command with the minus a option to activate all the swap area that are listed in the fstab file, but they are not currently active. And we verify with the free command minus lowercase m option, and you can see here that the total swap area configured on the system, one at the time of the OS installation and the 200 megabyte we just configured, both of them are active. And that brings us to the conclusion of the procedure on configuring a new swap in a disk partition. Check out the manual pages of the mkswap command, the swap on command, the swap off command for options and other details. Here's a list of my other video tutorials on Linux available for free on YouTube. Visit my website www.nixeducation.com for information on my books, tutorials, and available trainings. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Please subscribe to my channel, NixEducation, to get notifications of my new videos. Thank you for watching.